since the last exercise with determinations, I want to apply this equation of states to Jupiter. I do it with Jupiter because Jupiter is the best explored gas planet, so we have reference data to compare, and this is good because I want to look if this theory of the Lane-Empton equation give good results. And for Jupiter, I found out a crowd of variables here, in the, I showed in the top, for inserting into this EOS. And first I used n equals 1, the easy mathematics thing. With these, I came to a pressure in the center, what is really good, really good value, because the theory says, okay, we have 4 terapascals, and yes, I came approximately to 4 terapascals, so astonishing good. For temperature, I got a value what was not so good. It was, yes, a little bit too high, one order too high. And, okay, I looked then for n equals 3.5. That's a better warm dense matter approximation, but not so easy mathematics. And some parameters changed. And I determined PC and TC, what is, yes, really like the same as I determined before, so I can show, I could show that n equals 1 and n equals 3.5 is no big difference. In the last two exercises I wrote a big text, so I did a mind map to explain what I said in the text. So first, task 9, is the Lane-Empton equation a good model for these things? And first I have to say it's a fully mathematical model that have advantages and disadvantages. Advantage is that we have general universal laws that are, that work on every planet with warm dense matter. And we have easy derivations of these. I show it. It wasn't the big mathematics. And a disadvantage is that the temperature doesn't appear. And on the other side, we have to see physics processes. We don't think about physics processes. Now, let us look what follows out of this. So first, physics process we didn't consider was the shell structure, because in Jupiter, for example, we have a rocky core and a fluid envelope, and our mathematics, our differential equations and stuff are continuously. That isn't the same, obviously. And on the other side, we have also dynamical processes. So we have an energy transport, what is similar to temperature transport, and also a time dependency, so a cooling history. That means that the planet cools down over time. And if we would consider these two points, the temperature would shrink. And what we see was the temperature was too high. So maybe these considerations are maybe useful. And in the end, a big problem shows up, and this is really a big problem and a problem to solve, the found equations of states. So since the temperature doesn't appear, we used the ideal gas law, but that's maybe not the best equation of states in this case. So we need further theories, and further theories yield to this equation, what is not the ideal gas law and what works really good. But our density was good. So to find EOS, we need experiments and observations, and this is exercise number 10. So let us start with experiments, because yes, about experiments we did talk in the lecture several times. I think I should not explain what I mean with this, so diamond anvil cells, dynamic compression, isochoric heating. We talked about this in the lecture several times. But yes, with this we can think we can find out something about warm dense matter, and warm dense matter is in the center of such planets, so it's maybe useful. A thing we didn't talk about so much was observations, and first observations for the atmosphere. One can think that optical methods out of the Earth, that we do some optical methods for the atmosphere, would yield to a good result, but that's not so because of some physical reasons. So for the atmosphere we need space missions to understand this atmosphere. Then another region is interior. Here could help rotation figures because we have radial forces, and with these deformations of the planet, like I showed in this little sketch, I know it's not so the best sketch. And then also about gravitational field measurements, but the interior is better to understand with these experiments, because yes, rotation figures and gravitational field measurements are yes not so approved. And the third thing is evolution of giant planets, and here a big help is to explore new planets and look in which state they are, and then we can think about the evolution of Jupiter, for example. In the end, I want to summarize what one can remember about the Lane-Empton equation. And this is maybe this little edge of my sketch here. So we have, by the Lane-Empton equation, in case of self-gravitational objects, roughly good results by easy methods, easy mathematical methods. And this is maybe the thing to remember about the Lane-Empton equation, I think. And thanks for watching my video, and goodbye.